Well, we are starting off the day going to the thrift store, trying to get back in the swing of things. I've been painting for the past 3 days. I've been slowly moving stuff for the past week now. It's just been a mess. Today is currently Saturday. I'm gonna try to see if I can do a huge load, basically go to my storage unit, just load up mine and my friend's car and just bring a bunch of stuff to Miami. My inventory is currently still sitting at the storage unit as well as basically everything else. I only have a little bit of personal clothes, but a lot of the stuff is basically just sitting in the storage, so we need to get that. But I'm hoping we find something good today. You know, it's been a dry past couple days or so. We haven't really found anything crazy, so I'm hoping today, you know, we find like a nice little grail. Thrifting is basically like a casino. You never know when you're gonna hit big or when you're gonna lose. So let's hit up this first thrift store. Let's get it, guys.
Well, a few finds today. We found three of these sets: White Socks, Easy Sleep. Not really sure if it's new age or if it's vintage, but it does have like the old school Florida Marlins logo. You can see the Marlins on the front, then on the back. I'll have to look and see if they're dated. This one doesn't have the pants, and I don't know what team this is. I think this is just Michigan Rush Week, 1971. Found this goofy long sleeve. Ralph Lauren floral bathing suit. Spring break's coming up, so you know this will be an easy sell. And then the find of today, look at this single stitch on the HBO Simply the Best one size fits all made in the USA Tales from the Crypt HBO promotional. Insane find. We have this long sleeve mountain shirt, like the wolf howling at the moon. This I gotta look up, but we have the Beatles Love Cirque du Soleil. Official license, Beatles. This you always know. What's in the box? This is kinda cool, little Mickey. What I thought that was unique about it is the hood has ears on it. So we're gonna grab that. Fat Farm, you guys know, probably for the personal collection. Nice little Polo Ralph Lauren Essential red zip-up jacket. Another nice little Nike embroidered swoosh. I wish the swoosh was a little bit over, but you guys know, center swoosh, but still a nice little find. Now this is a center swoosh, basically. You have the nice little Nike little gray tag, the TN. And then brand new with a sticker from 1997, Florida Marlins World Series. I'm gonna grab this too. Super bright women's Patagonia little bubble jacket. I have this really nice oversized Adidas hoodie, like the pink colorway. We found two of these, nice little embroidered Kennedy Space Center, different colors. We have Coachella, 30 years on Earth, probably end up leaving that. What is this? Michigan Debate Institutes, probably leave that. I kind of just grabbed a bunch of stuff. Miami Hurricanes, New Age, I'll leave that. It's vintage Fruit of the Loom, I'll probably get this bear shirt. But other than that, nothing too crazy today. Only two t-shirts. I have no idea who this is, but I guess it's apparently like a music artist. I just love the graphic. And then we found this vintage whale shirt.
Well, guys, I asked for a grill and we ended up getting a grill. At least I think we got a grill, you know. I could be wrong, but that HBO promotional, like on the HBO tag, that single stitch, that shirt's gonna be crazy. I tried looking up, I can't find any other ones. I'm probably gonna end up listing it for maybe $500, take or best offer. Realistically, I could probably see it selling for $350. If it was a black tee, it would probably be worth even more. And if it had the characters, it would be worth even more. But the fact that it's a promotional shirt, it's on the HBO tag, HBO branded, people love promo shirts like that because they know that it's actual licensed, you know, stuff. And then we did find, you know, just occasional basic stuff, the NASA hoodies and stuff like that. But that Tales from the Crypt shirt will definitely be the money maker in today's video. Now I am quickly headed home. Let's check on Captain. I'm gonna make some breakfast. I think I'm gonna do English muffin with cream cheese, scrambled eggs with cheese on top. So let's go make some breakfast. Let's check on Captain. I'll show you guys the new apartment. I don't wanna show you guys too much because I'm gonna do a full reveal with the walls being black. I'm gonna try to finish the kitchen today. Yesterday, I finished the living room. I don't know if I'm gonna do my bedroom just yet. I really wanna do the living room and the kitchen first and then slowly start moving and stuff. And then if I wanna do my bedroom, I'll do my bedroom. But I don't really see the need to do the bedroom at the moment. I am gonna do a movie projector room in my bedroom, so one wall has to be white at least. So I don't really see the need of painting the other two walls. If the other wall is gonna be white, you know, I might as well just leave the bedroom white and then leave the kitchen and the living room black. But we'll see. I say that now, but I'll probably change my mind. We'll see how it goes. But let's check on Captain. Let's see how the little man's doing in the new apartment.
Little man, are you liking the new apartment? Do you like it, little guy? Are we gonna make some breakfast? Some nice breakfast in the nice kitchen. Should I go with Colorado stuff? Or should I go with some Goodnight Moon flour? This is local flour, actually. Like Florida grown. Definitely not comparable to Colorado at all. I'm gonna smoke some flour. I usually like smoking flour before and after meals, and then like dabs kind of throughout the night or throughout the day. Some GMO. It's looking lovely. We're probably about to have, let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, probably like a half ounce of oil left. We bought, I think, 30 grams, 40 grams, we're like halfway. So this breakfast is super easy. Basically, I did 4 eggs, 2 eggs per English muffin. Got the English muffins in here ready to go. I'm gonna add some cheddar cheese. I'm gonna add some pepper, some salt. Got milk to drink in the vintage Disney. I don't know if it's actually vintage. It doesn't have a year on it, but it's from McDonald's. It looks cool. I have the full set. And then we need cream cheese. Cream cheese to top it off. Oh no, it's stuck. Cream cheese. Eggs are done. English muffins cooking, ready to go. I'm using paper plates instead of my nice black plates that I got. I actually got a full set, but this is gonna be like for dinner, like when people come over. When it's just me, I'm just gonna use paper plates. So. Step one, toasted English muffin. Step two, cream cheese. Step four, egg. Step six, enjoy. So today's finds, we found a bunch of Harley stuff. Someone just dropped off all their Harley Davidson stuff. We have this long sleeve Barrett Harley Davidson. We have this white one, Barnett, El Paso, Texas, little pocket tee. This little pocket tee on the back. This yellow one's crazy. I love this one. Probably end up keeping this one. 2013 has the hits on the sleeve, HD on the back. Found this Alcatraz shirt on the crazy shirt. I'm probably gonna leave it though. I didn't realize all the stains on it. Dig dash dive. Harley Davidson. I'm going to say that a lot, obviously, because I found like 6 shirts, but nice little Peterson. We have this Cozumel, Mexico. This one's crazy. The biker, Jamaica. Then on the back hit. So sick. Super sick vintage Nike. Forest green with a nice little embroidery. Nice little Nike white tag. And then we found this wool Polo Ralph Lauren heavy coat jacket.
As I was leaving, they had a couple racks in the back and I just looked, I found another Harley Davidson white t-shirt, big orange logo. So we found probably like 10 Harley Davidson t-shirts. I wish we would have found jackets, hoodies, you know, stuff like that, but I'm good with t-shirts and they're bigger sizes too. So I may even keep a couple. You guys know how I like it, but you guys know I like the zip up sweatshirts and the zip up hoodies the best. If they had them, that would have been a home run for me. But now I'm gonna quickly go to Costco, get some gas. Gas is absolutely insane. The highest I've seen in Miami has been $4.25 or $4.20. Now, when you guys have been watching me, you guys know I was filling up for $2.40 for premium. Now it's ridiculous. It's just skyrocketing. So I'm gonna quickly go to Costco, get some gas, and we'll head to store number 2 and hopefully we hit good again. Let's see if we find some more Harley Davidson stuff. And you know, just keep the good day going. So let's get gas and let's get it, guys.